Let's talk about community servers for the console version of Rust. Because you, the player, were promised community servers months ago, and so far there's been no word of it, nothing. But from what we've heard from D11, there are a few things that we can piece together, and we can get a rough timeline for when community servers are likely going to be released for the console version of Rust. But before we get into that, please hit the subscribe button, because the subscribe button's lonely, and if you hit it, it's really not gonna do anything, but it'll make me happy. Anyways, let's get into it. So basically, community servers are servers that are run by the community. No duh. And I know you're thinking the console version of Rust doesn't have a community, but that slightly racist, degenerate, do nothing thing that we've got is still called a community, just like your neighbor who does absolutely nothing but smoke weed, or maybe that's you. Anyways, what we've got is a community, and community servers are going to be run by those players. Base idea behind community servers is more customization. Players can pay for servers, and then they get access to a control panel where they can set different things for that server. One thing might be the resource spawn rate. So if you wanted all resources to spawn at 69 times the rate that they normally do, you can set that. If you want players to spawn in with a gun and 420 rounds of ammunition, you can set that too. It's likely that if you wanted players to spawn in and not be able to build guns at all, you can also do that. There's a lot more options with community servers, and the base idea behind it is players can sort of customize the experience that other players get. In return, they're obviously paying for these servers, they're paying for the upkeep, and D11's pocketing a little bit of money. Now, D11, to their credit, has decided not to release community servers until it is a great experience for everybody. And this likely means this current gen and last gen. So a lot of issues are basically based around the Xbox One, PS4 iteration of the game, and the fact that certain things just don't work with it. And we're gonna go over that right now. So basically, in staging, some things have happened. D11's released build servers, and they've released PvP or aim training servers. And with those servers, we have discovered a few things. First off, build servers tend to get laggy as time goes on. This means that if you have a server with a very high rate of spawn of resources, it's likely that for players that are not on the latest generation of consoles, that is going to be an issue. When they first get into the server, it's going to seem like everything's A-OK because there's no one building around them. Then once players have logged in and built massive genitalia statues all across the map, everybody on last gen is having problem because dicks are popping up all over the place and it's causing their game to lag. And unfortunately, this is likely to be the case when you've got a high resource spawn rate. And that is basically what D11 is testing with a lot of these build servers. They can see what happens when a bunch of players come in, they build all these weird creations and then leave. And what you find is that a couple days into a wipe, those servers are pretty laggy. In addition to that, you've got those aim training servers. They're only letting 20 people in, but last gen consoles are still having issues with that. This means if you decide to create a server where everyone logs in, gets an AK, if you do more than 10 or 20 people, it's going to be an issue. And this is ridiculous. Let's just get that out of the way, because we've got games like Battlefield and Call of Duty that routinely do that number of players without any issues. That said, this is built on a completely different game engine that isn't optimized for consoles, so that's a big part of the problem. And as if that wasn't enough, we've also got issues with manpower when it comes to fixing bugs. And that's currently, when you release staging servers, there's going to be a lot more bugs because there's just a lot more variables for people to play with. And when everyone's spawning with an AK, they can do a lot more weird shit with. We take a look at the current state of Rust. D11 is lagging far behind in bug fixes. Something like the splitting bug, that should have been fixed within a matter of days or even a week or two, right? That would be fair, but it took them months to fix that. That is unacceptable in my opinion, because that was a bug that didn't exist previously. They introduced it. They should be able to roll back code, figure out how they introduced it, and take that bug out, but they were unable to do that, and it took them literal months to fix that issue, or maybe like a month or two, but it was still way too long in my opinion. When it takes them that long to fix bugs in production code, it means that when they introduce more variables, it's going to take them even longer to find, track down, and fix things that occur. Given all this, I don't think D11 is currently ready to release community servers. I think that they will be ready to go in 2022 in Q1 or Q2. Reasoning behind this is this. First off, in staging, we do have aim training servers, we have build servers, and we have larger maps. Larger maps are running okay, but aim training and build servers are having some very serious issues with last gen. Once those issues are fixed, it is likely that everything's going to be in place for community servers to launch, but what's probably going to happen is before community servers launch, you're going to see those aim training and those build servers come to production. When you see that, you've likely got a month or two left before community servers actually hit, drop, and everybody can sort of get in and start creating servers or doing whatever they want with it. So that's my take. My take is community servers are probably going to be coming out in 2022 in Q1 or Q2. When you see aim training and build servers drop in production, it's likely that we're almost there and community servers are going to be dropping within a month or two, but you really don't need to worry about that because if you hit subscribe, I'm going to let you know exactly when community servers drop because I'm on top of all this Rust news, so you don't have to be. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, peace.